chapter 24. Call your attention to verses 32 through 44, Matthew, first gospel, chapter 24. Call your attention to verses 32 through 44. Welcome in the house of the Lord. Sing praises in the house of the Lord. Give thanks in the house of the Lord. Matthew chapter 24. Reading from the King James Version. Beginning with verse 32. The word of our Lord reads. When we're ready to whip it, we do have time. Go away because we're on my floor. In the name of Jesus. Beginning with verse chapter 24. Matthew. Beginning with verse 32, the word of our Lord reads, Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, ye know that summer is nigh. So likewise ye, when ye shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be what? Fulfilled. Come on. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but what? But my words shall not pass away. But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came, and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Then shall two be in the field, the one shall be taken, and the other what?
Yeah.
Two women shall be grinding at the mill. The one shall be taken, and the other what?
Yeah.
Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doth come. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, come on, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Everybody together, verse 44. Therefore, be ye also ready. For in such an hour as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh. Our subject for this back to school message, prepare yourself now. Prepare yourself now. I have shared on some occasions in the past that in my work as a school librarian, I check out requested AV equipment to some classrooms. I have shared that I had the experience of being called by the teacher to say that the equipment would not work. Well, let me be the first one to let you know that I have no claim to fame as being mechanically gifted. But in my 65 years of learning, I have learned to troubleshoot by checking out the obvious first. Somehow, simple as it may seem, believe it or not, the cord had either come out of the socket or had never been plugged in. Mm. Attach the cord to the power source, and la voila, power on. The equipment worked just fine. Now, had I not prepared myself beforehand to check out all of the equipment that I knew the teacher would need to help with instruction, then I would have been responsible for hindering the particular lesson plans for that teacher. Instruction. Knowledge, wisdom, understanding, preparation. Ah, yes, preparation. Here we are on the second Sunday in August 2017, standing at the threshold of a new school year for first time and returning students of all ages prepared for the future now in different institutions, environments of learning. Well, I submit to you, it is no secret that our generation looks to institutions to recognize, identify, address, to solve situations, circumstances, conditions, issues, and problems that we face day in and day out. I submit to you, when it comes needs or concerns of mankind or the problems of society, we as members expect to find institutional solutions for the most part. Now, look at the controversy, if you will, surrounding the opioid epidemic in our country today. Anybody heard about that in the news? The opioid epidemic. It's always somebody else's responsibility to make decisions for me that I won't make for myself. Help me, Lord Jesus. In the same way, for many of us, when it comes to the work of Jesus Christ, we expect the church to do it. Thereby, this causes many of us to believe that such an important work, Lord have mercy, such an important work as the Great Commission must naturally fall on the church or the mission organization rather than on individuals preparing themselves now. Individuals preparing themselves now. Okay, you said all that, so what are you talking about, preacher? Well, as a builder must follow a blueprint for, let's say, a bridge, as a cook must follow the recipe for a meal, as a seamstress must follow a pattern for cutting cloth, as a teacher must follow a lesson plan to teach students, as a driver must follow the rules of the road, as a patient must follow instructions of a prescription, so must Christians, Christians, we which are called by his name, discover in words and deeds of Jesus Christ the guide for designing our lives, the guide for preparing ourselves now. Now I ask you, take a moment and look around this structure, this building, our church. Look, if you will, look front, look left, look right, look back, look ceiling, look forward. How many of you follow that way to get exactly what I asked you to do? Okay? Because some of these children spoke just like that. Thank you, Holy Ghost. A little humor, Lord. A little humor, all right? Follow instructions. Take a moment to take in the structure. Look at the organization, the meaning and purpose of each detail. Consider the location of the doors. Consider them as gates, spiritual gates, vital, of the utmost importance to your well-being as a Christian. Take a moment and look around this structure, this building, our church. Look, if you will, and take in the diversity of students, past and present. Students of all ages and achievements, and recognize the importance, the effort, and the effect of education on and through their lives. Consider their educational achievements at all levels as gates, vital, of the utmost importance to their well-being as lifelong learners and productive citizens. In the church, the keepers of the gate are the ushers. In the education setting, administrators, faculty, supporting staff, and parents are the keepers of the gate, the minds seeking the light that education can afford. In both examples, in both realities, if there is no keeper of the gates, if there is no security for the doors, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. There is vulnerability that compromises the strength. It denies and delays the continued growth and development as Christians growing in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord, and as students seeing an educational dream become a reality. Thank God for the mission-minded, dedicated, and determined, dependable visionaries who commit themselves and continually do so to keeping the connection across the generations, directing, discipling, disciplining our youth in the church, in the school, in the community setting. Well, I submit to you that there were those in this new church and new churches around this city, around this world, who chose to rise to the challenge of the Great Commission to get personally involved in bringing their children to Christ, establishing them in their faith, and then equipping them to share their faith with their peers. We have to get individually involved. I thank God for the sacrifices of those who wanted to pursue their own personal dreams, but duty to family, community, to employment, was a willing sacrifice to prepare others then, to prepare others now, to prepare others to come. Many wanted an education, a full education, but many, because of their love for their family, out of respect for needing to do what needed to be done, did not get as far along as they wanted to, but it did not stop with them, because they made the way for others who will come after them, and after them, and after them, and so it continues. Somebody hear me in here today. Jesus understood 2,017 years ago. Jesus understands today how easy it is to walk past and out there people who have made a way through our bridges for us still today. Some of us still don't appreciate what they have done. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, because we have attained, we are above and they are beneath. The devil is a liar. Lord, have mercy. Jesus understands that it may seem more glorious, if you will, to travel to exotic destinations, to fulfill the Great Commission. Jesus knew 2,017 years ago. Jesus knows today that special outreach ministry programs that take us into fallen territory sound exciting. Oh yes, just give me the title. Just don't ask me, expect me to beat the bushes, to go out in the hedges and highways, because I'm allergic to bushes and hedges, and I don't do highways. Yes, give me the title, but do not expect me to actually practice that Good Samaritan stuff. Just give me the title and a little something on the side to help me with my gas while I ride through those areas with my windows up and my doors locked. As part of Jesus' ministry on earth, he selected 12 men to become his disciples. And while he ministered to the needs of many, he spent his few years as a minister and a teacher, discipling a small group of men. Now, we ought to understand that because of his discipling method, Christianity did not fall by the wayside after he was gone, when he was alone on earth. But instead, it continued, that within a few years, that it had mushroomed and grew to a number that no man could count. You see, we have to understand that Jesus left disciples for his church who filled a purpose, not just a position. They filled a purpose, not just folks who come to fill the pews, you know, we call them bench warmers. And he has made it crystal clear that we which are called by his name are to continue to make disciples, preparing yourselves now. Oh, but we must be mindful not to just make any disciples. History teaches us that every high-profile spiritual leader had disciples. History teaches us that every political leader had disciples. Any present-day leaders come to mind by chance, by the way of President number what, 42, number 43? Moving right along. Be that as it may, we are not to be deceived. We are to make disciples of Jesus, just like John and Paul pointed disciples to Jesus. And we must be mindful that Jesus was intent upon making disciples, not in drawing crowds, and there is a difference. Jesus was intent upon making disciples, not drawing the crowds. You see, there's a meditation that I read some time ago that tells of a man who was a member of a particular church that had a reputation for being an active church. Perhaps you are familiar with this particular meditation. You see, the preacher had built the attendance by using gimmicks. But when he left, the crowd left also. The meditation continues that only a handful of people remained. You see, the church was then known in the community for its bickering and its meaning. And that can't tell me what I can't do. Help us, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
The church immorality was common among the members, and everybody knew it. Yes, the preacher had brought the crowds, but he had not made disciples of Jesus. Be mindful of who you attach yourselves to. We talked about it in Sunday school this morning for the children. Be mindful of how you allow yourself to become a attached to people and the reasons they're with. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Crowds can be built by accident. What happens when you see a car in an accident? Crowds may gather depending upon where the accident is, but disciples of Jesus are never made by accident. That takes planning and it takes purpose. Prepare yourself now. Yes, crowds can be built on the basis of providing entertainment. Just watch the crowds gather when a music group comes to town. But providing entertainment will not make disciples of Jesus. Enlightenment is what is needed. Now we have to understand that there's nothing wrong with drawing crowds to the place where we worship and study about God and His Son Jesus. It can be wonderful, but be mindful not to think the job is done just because crowds show up for special attractions. The real work is to focus on what to do after the crowd has come and after it has left. Now the Bible teaches us that Jesus drew crowds, yes. The Bible teaches us that on one occasion he had a crowd of 5,000 men plus women and children. And the Bible teaches us that he fed them all. Perhaps you are familiar with that story. Well, the next day they came again. But this time, Jesus did not feed them. You see, he knew that if the only reason they came to where he was to get a free meal, then the meal would become their master and not he. Ooh, Jesus, help me out. Help me, Jesus. Stay with me, Holy Ghost. It was then that he started teaching them, preparing them with a disciple-making lesson. The lesson plan being the Sermon on the Mount. But many walk out on that lesson. They give away nothing free. I don't want to be here today. I got to go. See ya. Don't want to be ya. They wanted food, not faith. They wanted loaves, not love. They wanted gifts, not demands. And so Jesus let the crowd leave. My question to you, would we do that? It depends on whether we see that the Great Commission says, go to the world and make crowds, or go to the world and make disciples. So many of us have it twisted, church. The truth be told, too many of us have it twisted. Let's not forget how we allow ourselves to get caught up in our desire to make everything instant. You've heard this before. We are so often caught up in making instant disciples along with our instant grits, our instant oatmeal, our instant rice, our instant tea, our instant whatever it is. Consider, if you will, in times past. You think about all the cars that the automakers made without that steel and how they rush to get those cars off that assembly line. And now look at the junkyards. You have all these cars that are there. Some of them good for getting parts, maybe. Otherwise, it's just there. But the Holy Ghost is giving you green light for this, so stop there. Pull out the church membership roll. Pull out the church membership roll and look at the inactive list in this church and any other church around and about. Casualties of instant disciples of Jesus. Somebody hear me up in here today. God does not want instant discipleship. He wants the stability of a mature faith that comes with patient teaching. Prepare yourself. Now, a disciple of Jesus is to live in such a way that people can see Jesus through him. That is one reason the church is called the body of Christ. For as a body allows a person to be visible, disciples allow Christ to be viewed, to represent Jesus, which it means to represent. R-E-P-R-E-S-E-N-T. Represent. To present him again and again and again. I ask you all the time, church, how are you living? How are you truly living? The direction and the expectation to righteous living is found in Matthew chapter 5, verses 13 through 16. Lord have mercy. Ye are the salt of the earth. But if the salt have lost his savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is therefore good for nothing but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all men, all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. I challenge you today that we remember and honor the legacy of faithful, loving service to Jesus as we follow the foundation laid, the foundation set before us by the leaders of this new church. I challenge you today that we remember and honor the legacy of faithful and loving service to my educational pioneers and present-day leaders dedicated responsibility to guard the gates, to protect the doors of educational dreams and pursuits. We must realize that God is for us. God is with us. But God will not force himself upon anyone. He will give you a choice. The choice is yours. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, should not have a choice, but have everlasting life. For God did not send not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Guarding the gates, we are preparing ourselves now to be an example others can follow to the goal of righteous living in Christ Jesus. Prepare yourselves now. People are watching. Prepare yourselves now. Children are needing us. Prepare yourselves now. Not to try to impress anybody with words or with titles or with what I have. Just let them see you have Jesus. Just let them see you have Jesus. And God will be pleased. Prepare yourselves now. Welcome in the house of the Lord. Welcome in the house of the Lord.